reconcile why we're here. We're not here to gain little green dollar bills. You know, we're not here to gain little trinkets. We're here to make the world a better place. And that's what we need to do. And that's what you can do in pararescue. That's what you can do in combat control. You do a little bit differently in combat control, but you're still doing great things. I mean, you know, they're the other half of the same coin, you know? Because you have to, sometimes you gotta kill. That's just the way it is. I mean, even in pararescue, sometimes you gotta do stuff. But combat controllers are dropping bombs on bad people. You know, I'm sorry. Don't be a bad person, and you don't have to worry about combat control. All right? That's just the way it goes. I love those guys. There's an honorable... everybody, if you're in one force, one fight, I don't care what you do, you're still supporting the people. You're doing what's right, you know? And if the military's not the thing for you, volunteer at a soup kitchen. Volunteer, you know, help them at an orphanage, rocking babies every once in a while. Do something other than what you just do for yourself. And if you do it for other people will do things for you. And I'm not saying that's why you do it, but I'm saying that I believe this is why all of this happened. You know, I've had people go, man, you're a marketing genius. You know, no, I'm not. This is because of all the good things that I tried to accomplish in my life up until this point, all the things I've done, this is the world saying, hey, let's help this guy out. That's all this is. And I am eternally grateful and totally mind blown and I can't say thank you enough. I'll hug everybody. You know, if you see me and you're like, hey, I tweeted this, or hey, I Facebooked this, or hey, I sent you happy thoughts and prayers, give me a hug. Hugs are important. You know, this is, we're people. We are people. People need contact. People need someone to talk to them. People need someone to listen to them. People need physicality. That's just who we are. You know, if we don't want it. Now, granted, I'm not saying go hug everybody. You know, Howie Mandel, awesome dude, does a lot of good for people. He doesn't like being touched by people, so, you know, not everybody. But I bet he likes to be hugged by the people that he loves, you know. And that's all right. You can just let in the people that you love, you know. And after a while, maybe you might be able to let in more people you love, because I'm sure at one point he only had a couple people he loved, and now, you know, he's got wife, kids, cousins, uncles, aunts, you know, grandmas. So, you know, people are in pain, and you gotta respect however they are, and just go with it. And that's life, you know. Respect other people and hope they respect you. But even if they don't respect you, you make them respect you. You show them that you're better than that, and that you're a human being and you're deserving of respect, because all human beings are deserving of respect, and all human life is equal. You know, the whole, if you could cure cancer but you have to kill one innocent child, no. I'm sorry. Greater good, yes. Killing an innocent child, nope. Can't be done. You know, my kids ask me, they're like, who do you love more? And I'm like, I love you guys equally. And they're like, blah, blah, blah. And I said, all right, if we're ever in a fire, you know, because they say the same thing, you can only save one of us. I'm either saving all of us, or I'm saving none of us. We're all dying together. And they're like, that's, blah. I'm like, but that's my love. And the funny, I don't tell them this, but the funny, I will get them out of the fire. We are not going to die, because I am not going to quit, and I'm not going to stop. You know, but should I fail, we're all dying together, because we're either all going home or none of us are going home. And I think that that's pararescue. I think that that's what we need. You know, you live next door to your neighbor and you're like, oh, he's got a Beamer. Well, shoot, I need a Mercedes. Well, then the guy next to you is like, well, I need a Maserati. Well, I need, you know, you know, Dude, that's awesome. You got a Beamer. Man, that's cool. I like Volkswagens. Beamers are cool, too. You know? You don't need to be better than the person next to you. We're no better than anybody. We're all equal. You know? We all have gifts. We all have talents. Some of us are good singers. Some of us are good speakers. That's not me. Some of us are good listeners. Some of us, you know, you have a gift, you have a talent, you just have to learn how to use it and live up to your full potential. My talent is I know how to rescue people. That's what I'm good at. That's what I was put on this earth to do, was to go help people in bad places so they could go home. That's why I'm here. So why are you here? Ask yourself that question, and when you wake up in the morning, be like, why am I here? What am I supposed to do? And do something. And I feel that you'll find that when you're on the right path, things go smoothly, things make sense, things connect. You're at the right place at the right time, and you're like, whoa, what happened? What just happened? Did that really just happen? You know, that's, I don't know. To me, that's God. It's synchronicity. It's all there, you know? I'm here for a reason. Find your reason and do it, you know? And so that's my message to you guys today is find your reason for being here and follow it. Do it. Make it happen. I mean, that's just... are we here in life? Someone's got a better idea why a bunch of monkey-like, somewhat intelligent people that we are, you know, are on this planet. It can't be for random. Even if it's for randomness, who cares? Even if we're all just randomly here, then it makes even more sense to do random acts of kindness, because there's no reason for nothing. So don't be an asshole, be a nice person. That's it. Spin that stuff. You know, throw that frown upside down. Whatever. There's no reason to be miserable. And if you are miserable, then reach out to somebody and be like, hey, dude, I got problems, man. I may need a PTSD dog or a cat or, you know, some kind of gerbil or a moonchow, you know, or a kangaroo. They're pretty cute. Don't go for koalas, because I've heard they're kind of violent, but, and they got them sharp claws, but they look cute, but, find your meaning, find your reason for being alive, and you won't be sad. It'll fill that hole. You know, alcohol isn't going to fill the hole. It'll numb the hole, and it won't make you care about it, but it won't fill the hole. Drugs might make you feel happy for a little bit. You're like, woohoo, having a great time. But it doesn't fill the hole. There's a hole in all of our hearts. And you just got to figure out what puzzle piece fits in there to fill it, to make it whole again. And that's my goal, my wish for all of you, is to find your goal and be happy, you know? Make the world a better place. That'll definitely make you happy. Trust me. It makes me happy. Or you know, maybe not for making the world a better place. Might be something else for you. But find what makes you... Find your joy. Follow your bliss. As Joseph Campbell would say. I love that dude. That dude's awesome. Remember, you could... Hero of 1,000 Faces. Wait, just about anything from William Campbell. William Campbell. Joseph Campbell. That's what I wanted to say to you guys today was, you know, find your bliss, follow your bliss. If your job is a job, it's not a job worth having. You know, if your life is just a life, it's not a life worth having. Make it mean something. So, thank you very much for listening, and have a good one. Hoo-yah.